We got potential contenders for that and right here on deck. We got Zomba's Rob, who was able to take it over Dill earlier, versus the king of skill checks. We talked about this off stream. Yep. John Numbers.
So I believe Zomba actually, 2 weeks ago, he was able to take Xeno over John himself, if I'm not entirely mistaken. So
might have been last week. I'm not 100% sure, but I know that Zomba definitely got a W recently.
Yeah.
And that is a hard thing to do in the House of 3000. All the competitors here, you got people like Numbers who just stall out anybody who wants to play a long-range game. But something with Rob, they're not necessarily a long-range game character. They got boxing options up close as well.
Yeah, Rob's got buttons right now, but Zomba is going to be struggling a little bit to find his way out of the corner. Tries to hit through his own gyro, but still going to be active enough in the re-hit rate. Still going to be able to go through him. Zomba not going to be able just to find his way out of here quite yet, but man, neutral hitbox, so friendly. It's like so comfy sometimes.
You're the first person I've heard call that friendly. Oh my god, that was not... what an interesting trade off of the side there.
And nobody died.
Yeah, I am so surprised nobody died. And right now, one of the big conditions, that one win condition that you need is definitely up throw, but also consistently making sure John Numbers isn't comfortable at the ledge with the really good ledge shopping that is Rob.
Yeah, for sure. Just throwing out gyro there and being able to cover the neutral getup lets you uniquely position yourself to be able to find those goal reads. So now Numbers going to be trying to find a way to catch Zomba, but I love this choice to go high instead of going from the ledge because Rob's...
Yo, we returned a monkey. I couldn't speak. I can't believe that volley. That volley was so close to catching Zomba in disguise. Still not even dead at 206.
Yeah, I just feel like it's so much more difficult for the Numbies to catch Zomba going high than if, oh my, this is such a nasty place for the Numbies right now. Is Zomba going to be able to find this edge guard? No, doesn't choose to commit to anything offstage. Just wants to play it safe with the down air.
Oh, that was so smart from Zomba. Now, you didn't get the KO, but yeah, you just go for it there. Even if you SD, that's fine. You're at 206. You're on borrowed time anyways.
Yep. That was such a good chase from Zomba. Just such good recognition that Numbers had nothing that he could properly threaten him with in that moment. And Rob, with a recovery like that, can go so deep. Just jumping in for free against Numbies. Look at all these landing mix-ups.
Oh, my God. And then cover it, like, just keeping the option coverages out there. Catch it to roll in. 222% on Zomba right now. Pretty much any trade works in favor of Numbers, but at this point, I think you start looking the game too.
Who tries to find that tech chase is going to be able to find it. I love that wave from Zomba, but so unfortunate he didn't find the punish.
You didn't die, but you got mixed so hard there. The falling up air, trying to call out a spot dodge, and reading the roll. Right, there you go, finally finds the KO, but we're pretty much near down throw up air. Well, actually, we are at down throw up air percents. Numbers has to be very careful.
Oh, but Zomba just getting a couple of these hits, but pressing far too many buttons on Zomba's shield there in that position. Grabs up, smash out of shield, covers both sides. It's deceptively fast. It'll kill you at like 90 to 100%. Yep. It does a lot.
And everything that sucks for Numbers in that position is the fact that Numbers pretty much can't go for zoning at that point. Because if you keep taking trades, it's just going to get worse for you. Take gyro hits, you're getting pushed off stage. You take any forward air hits, you're back off stage. Now you get to take a ledge trap. So I don't necessarily disagree with the idea of trying to go in, but maybe not the aerials on shield.
Yeah, Numbers is definitely getting really, really aggressive with it as he was struggling to be able to find ways to get in. But putting yourself in a corner against Zomba can be so risky, can be so dangerous. So Numbers has to be so careful that he's just not out there at the wrong time.
Yeah, and Numbers has to also change up the timing on where he decides to stall off stage, because we've already saw earlier, after the header and going for a ledge jump, got called out so hard on the side B. Now, oh, that was almost really bad, but a trade came in favor.
Ooh, going to be putting Zomba into a bit of a juggle. Numbers finally tacking on a good amount of percent. Just needs to be able to find this landing. I like the landing mix-up to go through the plat, but Zomba still covered it. Oh, wow.
Yeah, Zomba keeping this pressure up again. Go for down air timing. Good stall on the jump and avoiding any spot dodge call out there on the ledge.
Yep. And Numbers, wow, great positioning and spacing with header too. Just being able to jump and retreat with it and not get hit by Jaga quite yet. Love that mix-up from Zomba, but I love the awareness from Numbers even more. He was totally prepared for it.
I just jumped out my seat. That was such a good, like, bait. You just run at the ledge, force Zomba to think, oh, I can get aggressive here, and then run back, cover with F tilt. You keep yourself safe, and not so much.
Yeah. I like the idea from Numbers, right? He wants to hit Zomba's shield, put him in a bit of shield stun, then retreat, and back off in a really strange way, right? You wouldn't be ready for that, but then Rob's side B at ledge just covers 3 out of 4 options.
Remember when that was a bad move? I miss those times. those are safer times for everybody. Saying, oh my god, tries to go for like an air dodge through on the side B, maybe put him in position to try and catch him on a lower
recovery. Look at all these buttons. And Zomba like is just completely unchallenged through most of them. Numbers again, fishing so hard for these big early percent combos.
It's really a this is a war of one of the best hang at ledge characters, counter ledge trap characters, versus one of the best ledge trappers in the game. Okay, you were so lucky to die.
Yeah. Had Zomba held it a little bit more, that would have been able to do it. But Numbers finally finding that out-of-ledge option. But for how long? Just keeps on getting cornered over and over. Is going to be able to make the reversal. Love the idea, but a little bit too far.
I agree heavily. Love that idea. You haven't really gone off stage trying to cover a high recovery yet. So you try to go out there. You got deep breathing. That would have been a KO. So far, like back to even positioning. What are you seeing so far out of Numbers that looks really good in this change? All right, what about Zomba is looking really good right now?
I feel like Zomba has just been, again, like pressuring Numbers into corner and at the ledge, his own favorite place to be so well. If you can lock that down, you've basically got Numbers number on your phone on speed dial.
I honestly thought after I asked about Numbers thing, because we have a really big problem complimenting someone or bringing their name up and they die immediately after, I thought Zomba was going to die. Right now, things are looking grim once again. This is all best of three. That laser is going to force him off stage. You got to recover low. Do you avoid the downer? Yes, you do. It tries to call the jump out as well.
No.
Things are getting bad, Dara.
Numbers didn't take that like as an advantage to be able to get back onto the stage, and now puts himself in a corner again, that time gushing in when Zomba was in a position to whiff punish.
What do you even do? The get-up attack finally gets by. Now you have to pretty much...
Wow.
You don't have a KO throw option here. You need to find a deep breathing, maybe F tilt, or you just GG in a handshake.
Yeah.
That is Zomba taking it 2-0 over Numbers, absolutely shutting down all of what Numbers is strong at. And it just, it looked really well. It's not the easiest thing to do to be able to keep Numbers off the ledge like that.
So what I really liked about this from Zomba is because he was fully in a position that if John air dodged from here, you know what? You know what would happen? If he air dodged in this position, right? Instead of just getting hit by that gyro, Zomba would have been able to run out there, you know? Just right from here.
Enhance.
Zomba would have been able to run out here, occupy a space where John, his only stalls are going to be to like double jump and to like use side B. I like the idea. Maybe this was like a misinput from John, or maybe he did want to early dodge and was just a little bit too slow with it. But I would like to believe that he wanted to like intentionally get hit by that, because if you lose that early dodge in that position, you are dead. You're just done. Rob can go out there, chase you with side B. He can wait for you out ledge, hit you with forwarder, with downer, anything that he wants. Not having nail dodge, getting back onto the stage against Rob is a critical error. So, John was out of options.
And even with the stalls that WeFit has, you could throw a header out, you could go for Sun Salutation.
It
you
just
know
stalls.
Who doesn't care about that? Rob. Because of the laser, because of gyro, like you mentioned.
Side
and
B.
Also, and side B. So, like, if you decide to chill way too long, you get cooked. And that's just what happened.
Yep.
That matchup looked very difficult for Numbers, which normally Numbers is really good against Rob. It's just Zomba just had it.